In this video, we're talking about the photoelectric effects. The idea there is that you're hitting these metal samples with light, and the photons end up popping electrons off of the metal. Now, it takes a certain amount of energy just to remove an electron from the metal, and that's called the binding energy or the work function for that metal. And we're given this list of six different metals and their associated binding energies or work functions, listed from least to greatest, and we're asked which of these metals will not emit electrons when struck with visible wavelength light. So the typical scenario in the photoelectric effect is that a photon hits an electron. If its energy is bigger than the binding energy, it'll pop the electron right off of the piece of metal, and all the leftover energy, anything in excess of the binding energy, will go into the kinetic energy of that electron. What we're looking at in this problem is just sort of the threshold of, is my photon energetic enough to remove the electron at all? So what we want to focus on is the shortest visible wavelength of light. Anything that requires more energy than that to pop an electron off, you're not going to see any emitted electrons when you hit that sample with visible wavelengths of light. And you could have some debate about what's the shortest visible wavelength of light, and I'm just going to use the nice round number of 400 nanometers. I know it's somewhere in that neighborhood. And then I want the energy of that photon. So I use E equals HF, but then I can use the wave speed, frequency, and wavelength relation to rephrase this in terms of the wavelength. So I replace F with C over lambda, and I get HC over lambda for the energy. Now I proved this in another video, and I'll post a link to that real quick, but there's this super convenient fact that HC, if I express it in the right units, is 1240 EV nanometers. It's actually more like 1242, but it's rounded to three sig figs here. So look how fast this is if I remember that. I plug in the wavelength of my photon in nanometers, those cancel out, and I get my energy out in EV, which is the common units that we use when we talk about quantum mechanics and atomic physics and so on. So this gives me an energy of 3.1 electron volts. So the most energetic visible photons have an energy of about 3.1 electron volts. Then I just have to look through my list and find the cut point here. It looks like the top three metals have binding energies that are less than 3.1. So if we hit these metals with the full spectrum of visible light, we're going to get some electrons popped off by the violet light. Starting with magnesium, my binding energies are too high for visible light to remove an electron from the sample. So if you bathe one of these samples in just visible wavelengths of light, you're not going to see any electrons removed. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.